Under Armour.
Yeah.
Trump becomes president again, and with, not only withdraws it, but has workers dismantle what they've done on the porch. Okay, let's do that. Wow, gratuitous swiping. Yeah, that's Trump. Trump, outside of just the politics, just the facts, killed so many programs that spent any amount of money. Highway programs, I mean, he just didn't want to spend the money. Speaking of spending money, you gotta have your passport renewed. It's gonna cost you another $20. State Department raising the price from $110 for an adult renewing a passport booked by mail to $130. That, some people are pointing out, is an 18.2% increase, even though consumer price inflation rose by 6.8% without any seasonable adjustments.
Yeah, but how long has it been $110?
A long time.
Yeah, and the point is,
I'm not going to begrudge.
It's not something
that you have to do once every 10 years.
Yeah.
So this isn't the thing to get outraged.
No, it isn't. And by the way, just to lessen the pain, the government set up a U.S. passport office in Disneyland. So you don't really pay attention.
Oh my God, but that costs $1,000 to get to it.
So what's another stud?
Can you pay another $20 for the lightning lane?
It's a burger. All right, let's take a break. We'll come back, finish up handle on the news. Let's check in with Layla Muhammad.
Two people have died near San Francisco when their car was submerged in a flooded underpass. Forecasters say winter storms will bring flooding threats, snow, and bitter cold throughout much of the West through Christmas. The White House says the U.S. will lift travel restrictions to 8 southern African countries on New Year's Eve. Those restrictions imposed last month were meant to slow the spread of the Omicron variant of COVID-19. And the CDC is loosening rules that call on healthcare workers to stay out of work for 10 days if they test positive for COVID. Those workers will be allowed to come back to work after 7 days if they test negative and don't have symptoms. Checking out traffic on the 10 next.
Gettle Air Conditioning is contractor license number 1047-781. This is Ken Goodrich of Gettle Air Conditioning and Plumbing. You've already heard the story of how my dad asked me to hold the flashlight for him at night while he worked on air conditioners. Dad knew he was dying, but I didn't. You know the story. Anyway, one of the things Dad would have me do is replace all the screws the previous repair guys left out when they reassembled the unit. My job was to find every missing screw and replace it with a brand new one. I still do that today, and so do all my guys. When motors are whirling and compressors are compressing and electrical contacts are doing their thing, those non-stop vibrations caused by missing screws will cause your system to die long before it's time. That's why we tied your unit down to factory fresh condition on every service call. My guys are perfectionists. No squeaks, rattles, or hums. And don't forget our awesome duct tester. Gettle. G-O-E-T-T-L. It'll keep you cool, but it's hard to spell. Call us.
Now through January 3rd, during the BMW Ultimate Road Home Sales Event, see a Southern California BMW Center for a credit of up to $2,500 on select models. Visit BMWUSA.com/roadhome for details.
Wet and cold out there, highs in the 50s to near 60. This report brought to you by the Southern California BMW Center. There is a crash in the tent.
Boy, there sure is. This crash is all over the place. So please do be careful if you just joined us now. It's pouring again in the San Fernando Valley. But to West LA now, this is the eastbound Santa Monica Freeway at Robinson. An overturn, a really bad sounding crash. Another big trying to get it over to the shoulder instead to shut down all lanes to do it. So it's going to be real close. After that, lanes are cleared into downtown Los Angeles. But be careful. Problem continues now. This is left over from yesterday's rain. South 710 on Laundry before the 91 was flooded. The whole thing was shut down. Since this morning, only the left lane open. Both from the 105 going to LAX, the problem. On the westbound 105 at Long Beach Boulevard, something always seems to happen. I don't know what it is, but carpool lane blocked back up from the 710. And the valley, a final thing. South 405 at Valley Vista, a bad crash. And eastbound 101 at Haskell, another bad crash. Boy, it's tough driving. Be careful. Kfi in the sky. Hope to get you there faster. I'm Jeff Barlow.
This report is sponsored by Anthem Blue Cross.
and from Blue Cross and Heart of America are helping schools across the country increase their access to healthy food. Learn more at anthem.com/PA/SPART. Anthem Blue Cross is the trade name of Blue Cross of California.
Was the night before Christmas, and someone in your house was tossing and turning like an insomniac mouse.
So simply, you should go for the best gift of all, a great night's sleep for once and for all.
It's Sit and Freak year-end clearance sale. Save up to 50% off all the best brands. Plus, with your good credit, get 0% financing for 24 months with your minimum monthly payment.
So don't let your old mattress fill you with fright.
Trust your sleep to Sit and Freak, night after night.
Hey, Mario Lopez here, and I don't know about you, but I am stoked to get outdoors again, dining at restaurants, watching live music. It's so great to have it all back. But with privilege comes responsibility. Make sure you're doing your part to help reduce the spread of COVID-19. Getting tested is easy at COVID clinics. Go to covidclinic.org to book an appointment at no cost to the patient. COVID clinic has locations conveniently located all throughout the state. So visit covidclinic.org to find the closest one to you. Again, that is covidclinic.org.
Ah, oh, girl, thank you. You're a lifesaver. No problem. So it's something with my car. I love a new car like yours. Actually, it's not new. It's a Toyota certified used car. Wow, looks new. Drives great. Well, the thing with Toyota is that from top to bottom, gives me great warranties. And, you know, it's a Toyota. Huh. Mind dropping me off at a Toyota dealer? Good move.
The best new cars make the best used cars. And now you can get 0.99 APR on any used Camry, Corolla, or any of the RAV4 family. Along with a 160-point inspection, you get a 12-month or 12,000-mile limited comprehensive warranty and 7 years of roadside assistance from the date of purchase. For all warranties, see dealer for details. Not all customers will qualify. Limited term financing through Toyota Financial Services. Must take delivery from Toyota Certified Used Vehicle Dealer stock by midnight January 3rd. We make it easy. Toyota, let's go places.
Radio advertising can connect your business with holiday shoppers wherever they go. Use iHeart Ad Builder to create an affordable custom radio ad right on your phone. Just click, listen, approve, then hear it on the radio. Create your customized ad today at iHeartAdBuilder.com.
Get to the Ford year-end sell-a-thon today for holiday deals you won't want to miss on Ford's toughest truck and most popular and versatile SUV. Don't wait to bring in the new year with the new Ford. This year-end sell-a-thon ends soon.
All right, let me tell you about Sunday. All right, my friends, it's Sunday. They can sell your home fast with no repairs, no hassle of showings, realtors, cleaning, or making upgrades. Sunday, they are the best, right? And they have free no obligation cash offer. They're going to visit your property, do a 3D walkthrough, and the package all the property details up, send it to thousands of local investors. And then over the next week, the average homeowner receives 12 offers on their property. It's like a mini bidding war going on your property. It's quick and easy. Then they can close in as quick as 10 days. That means you can be out before Christmas. Maybe up to Boise, Idaho, right? A huge ranch up there. You may also be eligible for a $10,000 cash advance. So let's phone them up. 825-OFFER. 825-OFFER. Or the website, it's Sunday.com, Sundae.com. Send California licensed real estate broker to your license.
Hi. We're home.
Can
you talk to Dr. Daryl Perlstein? He's a thoracic surgeon at the Ho Family Cancer Institute. He loves the outdoors and hiking. He's also a leader in robotic-assisted surgery. He trains other surgeons nationwide. Dr. Perlstein would love to get to know you and is ready to make a positive difference in your family's life. Get to know Hoke. Visit HokeHealth.org and find your physician today.
Tens of thousands of homeless defecating the streets, guys dying in the streets, mental patients, drug addicts. Now we got smash and grabs, huge amounts of garbage, murder rate, highest it's been in many years. Again, the accomplishments, there's mayor's committees. The Olympics. It's all committee 7 years from now. John and Ken.
Weekdays at 2.
They sit and they blather about nonsense they can't possibly fix.
On KFI.
I didn't get
a
letter on a new TV. I didn't get Sopranos on DVD.
Good morning, Bill Handel. Morning, crew. December 24th, Friday. Going to be raining right through tomorrow.
And then starting, I think, early next week or mid next week, another major storm is coming through. So we need it. Although, I'm not a big fan of the rain. I hate it. Cold, it's wet. You know, that's a brilliant analysis. Rain is wet, but it's still pretty miserable.
It needs to, what we need to have is regular rain from midnight to 4 a.m.
Yep.
Okay, work on that, Wayne. That sounds great.
Yep.
Hey, the prices we pay to live here,
yeah,
the cost of living, we deserve weather scheduling.
At the moment.
No. It's rain term, right?
No.
No, Chris. No.
Oh, you, okay, I thought, what do I think you're into a lot?
I'm sorry, I'm trying, guys. Okay, so another woman has come forward accusing, and when I think about Chris Knox, I think of Sex and the City, right? He's one of the first men, that show. Has accused him of sexual assault. So the latest came out yesterday. Lisa Gentile, a singer-songwriter, she came forward to allege that he assaulted her in 2002, and she said that she didn't come forward at that time because he threatened to blacklist her and, you know, ruin her career if she said anything.
Enough women have come out where there's some legs to this story, and I don't doubt this at all, where you have a major star or someone with a lot of power threatening to kill a career if you don't.
Now, he says everything was, he said it was all consensual, but they're saying it wasn't.
And by the way, you don't know the difference, because again, you're just talking allegations, but there are enough of them out there. For example, Bill Cosby, absolutely not guilty. And his wife said that after he was let go because of the judge simply being wrong jury instructions, you see, he's innocent. He's innocent. He didn't do that. And that is, that's the narrative. I mean, where's reality? Excuse me?
Well, speaking of this sort of thing, former New York Governor Andrew Cuomo won't face criminal charges for an incident where he allegedly, he was at an event on Long Island, and there was a female state trooper there who was holding a door open for him, and she says that he ran the palm of his hand across her abdomen, down to her belly button, and then over to her right hip, which was the gun carrying hip. So the DA said, well, this is disgusting, and it's terrible. It doesn't fit any existing crime on the book, what he did, because he didn't touch her in that door that would make it immediately a crime.
Although putting his hand, his palm, and going across the breast.
No, it wasn't on her breast.
It was just the abdomen.
It was just
the sternum and then the sternum down.
Button to the hip, where the gun was. Isn't that still a battery?
Well, you would think so, wouldn't you?
Without unwanted touching.
Yeah, but it's such a low-level misdemeanor. You know, what does...
Yeah.
Although it's Cuomo, so... You know.
I think we could all agree that normally we don't like to see the criminal justice system pile on a person unnecessarily, but in his case, we might make an exception.
Yeah.
A man has a thing for wearing a diaper and having people change his diaper. So follow me on this. It's a guy in Louisiana, allegedly. He was arrested for hiring caretakers by posing as a person with special needs who needs his diaper changed. And so he would bring in these babysitters to care for him and change his diaper. And then wanted them to bring in other babysitters because he likes to get the diaper changed. He was charged with human trafficking and attempted human trafficking. And
I don't know if you remember this.
Yeah.
We had the story of this exact gentleman the last time he was arrested for doing this.
Yeah.
This is the second time now.
Now, why did he quibble with someone else's story? I mean, I just don't get it.
Well, I think the problem here is that he's lying to people.
Oh, that's
if you say, I'm a perfectly healthy adult man and I like to wear a diaper, and would you take money to change my diaper?
Right, there's a market for that.
And a person says, sure, I'll do that, you have no problem.
Right, there's a market for that.
The problem is lying and saying that he actually needs this medically because he has special needs when he doesn't.
I'm still trying to figure out what's wrong with this.
What's wrong with the lying part, or what's wrong with liking to be an adult man wearing diapers? and treat it like a baby at 31.
Wait,
however,
we have to pin him down.
Are you saying you don't have a problem with him lying?
No, I do have a problem with him lying.
But the other part is,
everybody's their own thing.
If everybody understands what's going on and agrees, something like this, I just nod.
Well, I mean, I'm getting close to that time anyway. But legitimate, like, diaper change.
This is a serious question. It really is serious. I'm not trying to be funny. If you have this fetish or whatever this is, because it's infant porn, do you wear adult diapers that will fit you, or do you try to wear actual diapers for a baby for method acting authenticity?
You know, I don't think, I mean, you can't even get into a child's diaper if you're a reasonably sized person.
He looks pretty skinny.
Yeah, but I still love
it. I just have questions.
So doesn't that ruin it when you're buying the diapers and it says right on it, adult diapers?
Yeah, probably.
Like if Daniel Day Lewis was in a movie playing a baby, and we know how immersive he is, and they brought him adult diapers, wouldn't he have a tantrum on the set that it was ruining his method?
It's also an issue of the chafing. I mean, I'd really be concerned about that.
Lately, you had powder and the whole thing.
Lately, you got something to say real quick?
I just had questions. Like, at what point in this grown man's life did he miss this? Like, did he miss this throughout college? And he just kept on with the diaper and the powder changing? Or did he wake up at 30 and say, I want a diaper with powder?
You know, we should bring in a psychologist, as I guess.
Or if I don't know what to do.
That would be good, too. Probably need a Google.
Oh.
All right, we're done.
Circling around his nap time.
The history of Santa Claus. Now, we do this every year, but everybody knows St. Nicholas. Everybody knows the Coca-Cola Santa Claus. But there is a whole history in between, and I'm going to jump on that when we return. KFI AM 640, live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Powered by burning all the coal that filled our stockings. Black Christmas.
KFI.
KOST HD2.
Los Angeles, Orange County.
Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
I'm Layla Muhammad, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. A teenage girl was shot and killed by friendly fire during an assault inside the Burlington store in North Hollywood.
LAPD officers were sent to the store after 911 callers reported a man assaulting a woman. When officers arrived, they saw the man hitting the woman with a heavy cable lock. Officers opened fire, killing the man, and at least one of the bullets went through a wall behind the man on the other side, a dressing room with a 14-year-old girl inside. The girl died on scene.
We have not reviewed the video, the CCTV, the body-worn video, but until we do that, we don't have any further information.
Assistant Chief Dominic Choi says the injured woman was taken to a hospital. He says it's not clear why the man targeted the woman. Chief Gregory, KFI News.
The California Attorney General's office says state investigators will review the fatal LAPD officer involved shooting of that 14-year-old girl under AG 1606, which became law in July. The state DOJ must investigate uses of force by police where an unarmed person was killed. Now, a month after the shooting yesterday, the DOJ Southern California Police City Investigation Team was sent to the scene in North Hollywood. The results of their investigation will be given to the state special prosecution section for review. The rain will stick around through the holiday weekend. Forecasters say rain will be off and on and heavy at times. There's been 2 to 3 inches of accumulation in most areas of Southern California and even more in the higher elevations.
Some of these mountains have picked up literally half a foot of rain since yesterday, and that's pretty astounding. We could end up with more rain this December than we had all of last year's rain season put together in L.A.
Cal State L.A. meteorologist Ilya Neiman says heavy downpours in some areas could lead to flash flooding this morning. And an evacuation order has been put into effect in Silverado, Williams, and Majestic Canyon in Orange County. The rain caused a mudslide last night in Silverado Canyon. The National Weather Service has issued a flood watch in effect for coastal and inland Orange County. Officials in Orange County say an oil sheen off the coast of Huntington Beach seems to be drifting towards the Long Beach area. The sheen was detected Wednesday about a mile off Boca Chica State Beach, according to the California Department of Fish and Wildlife. Some tar balls came ashore yesterday in Huntington Beach, despite the presence of protective booms. The Rose Parade in Pasadena is still set to float as planned. However, there will be COVID-19 precautions for fans.
Those measures include requiring fans who sit in the grandstands to show either a proof of vaccination or a negative COVID-19 test. Pasadena Tournament of Roses CEO David Eves says The organization is asking people who walk up on the parade route to also do their part.
So stay with your family, stay with your pod, socially distance, wear a mask at all times, and the most important is get vaccinated.
Steve says the organization is taking its direction from the Pasadena Health Department in planning the event. He says at this time the department does not see a need to change the current plan. In Pasadena, Blake Crowley, Kfi News.
News brought to you by Rear Hero. Los Angeles County has reported more than 8,600 new cases of COVID-19. That's a 33% increase from Wednesday. According to the county, the average daily rate of people testing positive for the virus rose to 6.6%. The county also says there were 24 COVID-related deaths yesterday. The Omicron variant has surged across the country with heavy effects on holiday air travel.
United Airlines canceling over 100 flights. Delta also canceling around 90 flights, pointing to the spike in COVID cases limiting crew availability.
That's ABC Jackie reporting from Washington. At least 30 people have been killed on board a ferry in Bangladesh. A fire started on board that ferry while sailing the Suganda River. This happened around 3 in the morning. 72 people were rescued from the ferry. Let's head back to the 101.
You betcha. Good morning, boy. If you did, Sean, just be careful. You can roll out and pay questions here very, very quickly. First, the drive out of the west end of Miami Valley going in towards Encino. There was a crash. Eastbound 101 on asphalt. Pretty bad one, too. Bunch of drivers involved, rig, cars, yada, yada, all that stuff. But the backup is going away now. I've got it over to the shoulder. But if you keep going now, once you get past the 405, you make it right turn from East 101 Ventura to the South 101 Hollywood, new to L.A., you'll get used to this. But at Lancaster, right outside Universal, there's another crash there. Once you get through all that, pretty good drive downtown Los Angeles. Now, back to the valley for a minute. South 405 at Valley Vista, a very steady crash there. Still has your slow from Burbank Boulevard. That's not too bad in distance. Once you get going over the hill, you'll be okay. Quickly, San Bernardino Forest. Highway 18 is shut down now in both directions. Happens a lot. Rocks and snow and what have you. It's closed in between Oregon and Highway 138. More on that as the morning continues. Tough driving. Be careful. Kfi in the sky. Help get you there faster. I'm Jeff Ball.
The Lakers closed out their Staples Center era with a dismal 138-110 defeat at the hands of the San Antonio Spurs. Here's LeBron James after.
Oh, yeah, that thing about the Spurs, they always like to shoot. They always shoot for 24 seconds and break down and make it back. And they've been one of the hottest teams in the league over the last 10 years in professional basketball. Every mistake that we had, every breakdown we had, they made it fit for us.
I'm Wayne Resnick, Kfi Sports.
It's easy to take life for granted, but a serious accident that injures you can really change the trajectory of your life. And it happens in an instant. Sweet James, accident attorneys know firsthand how unjust and unfair the legal system is to victims of accidents. And that's why their army of winning and passionate attorneys fight for thousands of injured accident victims every day to ensure that they get the medical treatment they need, get help with their car, and settle the most amount of money possible. You don't want to take it on alone. In fact, an independent study revealed that the average person got over 3 times the money with the right attorney than without. Insurance companies say they're on your side, but they're not. If you're ever hurt in an accident, call Sweet Game at 800-500-5200, 800-500-5200, or SweetGame.com.
Living with someone who tested positive for COVID-19 in the past 5 days, those 18 and older who are not vaccinated may be able to take part in a clinical trial for practical medication to prevent COVID-19. This trial is not for a vaccine, but participation is voluntary. Participants will receive study-related care at no cost and will receive reimbursement for study-related time and travel. To learn more, visit COVIDMoveAhead.com. That's COVIDMoveAhead.com. Sponsored by Merck.
U.S. stock markets are closed today for the Christmas holiday. The average price per gallon of regular gasoline in California is $4.66. Southland weather from KFI. We have some morning showers, a chance for storms. And then we will have more showers this afternoon. High around 60 from the beaches to Metro L.A. and O.C. Mid-50s to around 60 in the valleys and I.E. Right now it's 57 in Fullerton, 58 in Costa Mesa, 55 in Santa Monica, 54 in Covina. We need 12 live on the KFI, 24 hours in the room. I'm Rachel Hines.
Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, and it's down Santa Claus' lane. He doesn't care for your stuff, for he loves you just the same. Santa Claus, you're all got children, that's my favorite new ride. So fill your heart with your treasures,
and good morning, everybody. Hello, and the morning is here. It is a day before Christmas, and later on, the 12 days of Christmas, which, by the way, starts on Christmas Day, and in the story of the most annoying carol that ever lived. Right. Now, every year I do this story, but every year we forget that Santa Claus actually has two origins. One, Saint Nick. And then moving forward to, I think it was the 30s, when Coca-Cola did its ad, and all of a sudden, Saint Nick became Santa Claus, which is still there too, and he is jolly and fat, and the beer, and the clothes, and all that. So, the story of jolly old Saint Nick begins with Saint Nicholas. Early Christian bishops had to be incredibly generous, and this is the third and fourth century. Is when that came about. And what he did was gave away his gold and traveled the countryside of what is now basically Turkey. And sales of Nicholas helping people in need were spread for decades. And then ultimately he becomes this saint in Europe. Now, written records of saints during that period, of course, are very scarce. Written records about anything are very scarce. But there are surviving tales and suggest that Nicholas did wear those red robes. And his name, historians are theorizing, because we really don't know, that those red robes contributed to the evolution of Santa. And his name, Santa Claus, if you take the Dutch nickname for Saint or Saint Santa Claus, it is Sinterklaas. Or Sinterklaas. Sounds an awful lot like Santa Claus. And then the story makes its way to the U.S. and then receives attention in the late 1700s because the Dutch immigrants, remember a lot of this started in Holland, and when the Dutch immigrants go to New York, they bring along their belief and their story of Saint Nick and Santa Claus. Well, by the early 1800s, then you have American merchants and artists and writers. Let's forget the historic saint, and let's start talking about tales about it, and let's talk about Santa Claus. And the New York Public Library credits a guy named John Pintard, Washington Irving, the famous author, Clement Clark Moore, and Thomas Nast, one of the great poets. Transforming, this is actually Colin Flynn, prior to the big So now we move forward to 1849. And there's a written fiction work. That's been part of a German-American cartoonist.